Okay. So last week we talked about the top level view of OreSat. So today we're going to go into the helical antenna, which is located here on this N card, the positive Z N card, and OreSat Live, which is located below it.
Real quick,
I'm not sharing my screen. That is a good point. thank you.
Recording is on.
Okay.
Recording is on.
So, yes, today we are going to talk about the helical antenna, and that is located on the positive Z N card, and OreSat Live, which is located below it. And this top cap here, the positive Z end cap, really doesn't have much on it. The only thing that will go on it is magnetometers, which are going to basically monitor Earth's magnetic field, and then we'll use that with the magnetorquers, which work with the reaction wheels, which we'll go into at another time. So, helical antenna on the positive Z N card. It's very long. And we've got, right now, these strips are representing Kapton tape or Kapton film. And the reason for that is we need this to be very straight when it's in space. And so the idea is that the antenna will be manufactured to be a little bit longer and more spacing between each turn, so a bigger pitch, and we'll use that Kapton film or tape or possibly string to keep it in compression so that it's got that vertical compression keeping it straight, if that makes sense. And so three, just to keep it really constrained around the sides. And the dimensions of this are mostly dictated by RF properties that we need it to have, which is why it is quite long. And so then we've got Jim's deployer, which is relatively new, and that's something that Calvin also worked on. And the idea is that it will flip open like a lid, so it will keep this constrained below it, and then it will have burn wire located here, which I'll get into in a second, and you burn it, and then that will lift open, and this can deploy. So burn wire, for those of you that don't know, is basically fishing wire, and it's connected to your circuit board via a resistor, and as many of you probably remember, when you heat up a resistor, or when you put current through a resistor, it gets hot, and so you get it hot enough, and that fishing wire burns, and so it's a burn wire, and it just releases the wire. And some things with this, as with all CubeSats, is you can't have anything come off, so everything has to be attached to your CubeSat at all times. So even with that wire burning, we have to keep at least one end connected to the satellite. And these connectors right here are for the solar panels. So the solar panels have two on each side, so four on the positive side and four on the negative side, and those will connect in to this card to get them down to the batteries. This right here is the debug connector, so that allows us to do electrical things when everything is put together, because obviously we've got that positive X side that goes on, and then this allows them to get into all that good stuff with everything put together. So the end cap goes on and it's got a little hole there, basically. Once again, this is from a mechanical standpoint, so I'm not going to get too into the nitty-gritty of the electrical details. So, Jim, do you have anything that you think is relevant to talk about for helical?
I think you covered everything pretty much.
Okay. So, the other thing is we've got this hole cut out in the center here. That is for OreSat Live to point through. We do need that camera to point through the entire helical, so we are pretty much hoping that it's going to be focusing on something so far away that the helical won't affect it. That's Andrew's theory. We'll see how that goes eventually.
Do we have the OreSat Live camera already picked out?
Yes and no. We have one that we're going to go with if we can't get a better one. But Andrew is working on getting a better one picked out.
Right. So, well, let me be more specific. The camera is picked out. It's a USB Sony sensor. The question is, can we get the good Cassegrain grade lens that we've always wanted? So it's a question of the lens at this point.
Gotcha. So, makes sense.
So, yeah, and obviously we've got some mechanical issues to work around where you've got a giant hole here. And if you don't know much about antennas, which I didn't really either, the helical antenna and any antenna has a ground plane, which is what the card is acting as. And so there are some requirements between what size hole you can have in that end plane. And so this is really kind of pushing it. This hole is quite large. And so Glenn will have to do some testing to make sure that it doesn't interfere. And then also, obviously, our helical has a diameter, so we can't have a hole bigger than the helical because then the helical is just going to slip through. But we still need it to be mounted, so we've got the screws here. So it's a lot of different parts working together and very difficult. We also have a vertical constraint due to the nanoracks or whoever is going to deploy us. They don't want us to stick out past the rails, and so that all makes things difficult. So any questions about the end card, positive Z end card? No? Okay.
I do have one quick question. The end cap that we have right now doesn't allow for the current size of the deployer, right? It's an old model. Okay. So make sure I've not updated that yet.
And one last thing, too, is that the helical antenna is basically one half of the OreSat Live communications. So if you take a look at the handheld ground station, it's got its own helical antenna to match so that we can send that video from OreSat Live, which is of the student or whoever makes the handheld ground station, their location. We'll send that video down via helical antenna to their helical antenna on the handheld ground station. And that's how they're getting it. So that is why OreSat Live is located there. And this is what it looks like. It's quite simple right now. Not too much to talk about. So this board here was something that Andrew handed to me in the rocket room and said, make this in CAD. So I did my best. And this I just extended. It doesn't actually go that far up. We'll need to make something so that the lens doesn't rattle around. But this is the current lens that we're planning on using. And we've got some space here cut out. And we've got it on standoffs because this board has components on it that stick up and you don't want the two boards to be super close. And we flipped these fasteners around. Oh, I lost it. Because there's a board below it as well. And since we're going far below the board, I think we're about 2 millimeters, then any components on the board below it are gonna stick up. And so we just wanted to make sure that this is as close to the board as we can get it, and obviously these locking hex nuts are a bit tall, so flipped it around. And when I go through how to make a card, I'm going to make this one, so if you're interested in how I did that, I'll make a video for it. I feel like such a YouTuber. But anyways, just looking at the card, I think I want to go into some of the details of the card while we have a couple minutes. So this side with the little notches goes on to the back plane, and the frames have a little 45 chamfer right there, which is what this is for, and that's just to help guide it to make sure it's centered. So you slide it in and it kind of follows like a ramp, and it gets it nice and centered because we'll have connectors right here, which I don't have on yet. And we want to make sure that those get put nicely in. We also have cutouts right here, which are for the fasteners that keep the backplane on. And those aren't all the way down, but it's easier to make one standard board that has those cutouts in it and so that we know that we can move the cards around if needed and we don't have to worry about changing that. And then this side is the positive X frame, which has some funky cutouts, and it's always fun to put it on. And then these sides are just the Y sides, and not very interesting at all. And once again, we might not have RF connectors on all three. So these are, if you look in CAD, they're gold, and those are for Glenn's communications purposes, but we just have three in there just to make everything standard, so it's not having to change things around. We can just assume that there's three and then work around it. Makes things a lot easier, which is one of the goals of OreSat, again, is just to make everything standardized the best that we can. So, cool. See, that did not take long at all. Any questions about helical antenna and OreSat Live? No? One thing I do want to point out, if I can get the sketch to show. So right here, you can see there's a circle. So all of the boards, which when I make my video, you'll see that they've all got this sketch in it, which is why we try to make our boards off of the generic board. And this circle here marks the center of OreSat. So because we have the backplane, the center of the cards is not the center of OreSat. So we have to have a separate marker because so many things need to be centered in the satellite. So, and I think I covered this last time, is then I went and made these concentric. And that's just a great way to orient yourself. And then I also made the helical antenna concentric on this circle. And because this circle is the same on both boards, the center of the satellite, the helical antenna and OreSat Live are concentric. So, and I'll get into what all the other sketches mean when I make that video. And it'll be a good time, fun time. Cool.
Thank you.
Thanks, Catie.
All right, so that is it.
Very cool.
And stop.